on the parent survey, we asked you, my child is given the opportunity to solve real world problems within the community, and only 54% of you agreed, which is very less. And we actually agreed that there isn't enough opportunity to solve real world problems. So we came up with a solution for that. The goal of our school is to make students change makers. And one of the ways you become change makers is if you are global citizens of the world that you live in. While the ICSE curriculum allows you to build a lot of knowledge and competencies in terms of skills, it doesn't give you enough opportunity to apply it. And so what this global citizenship program will do is give you the opportunity to apply the knowledge and skills that you're learning across other subjects to solve real world problems. And we spent this entire year doing a lot of research on what that looks like. And what we found was students learn and develop citizenship qualities best when they solve civic problems in the communities in which they live. So solve real world problems related to social and environmental issues. So what we're going to do is, we're going to teach students about the rights and responsibilities using the Constitution of India, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, and the problems that we've picked to teach them about the rights and responsibilities is coming from the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. So they'll be studying about things like climate change, gender inequality, class divide, through a class that is specifically designed to help them take civic action. So we want them to be agents of change so that they can stand up for their rights and at the same time be responsible for helping those around them who need it. So this past year, we had the opportunity to do a really small pilot in grade 4A. So 40 students were part of this pilot, and through this year they studied about problems such as child labor, climate change, and the water crisis. And instead of me telling you more about what we did, I wanted to hear from some of our students about it.
We are also learning about climate change, education, and the people who are against climate change. They want to, there are activists like Greta Thunberg who are against climate change.
And why is it important for you to learn about these things?
Because if we learn today, we can improve the world in future.
I really like this class and it helps me to understand why it is so important to be a global citizen.
And what if I don't want to be an activist, right? Is it still important for me to learn about the things that you learn about in citizenship?
Yes, it doesn't matter if you want to be or don't want to be. Even if you don't be, it's okay. But at least you should know the awareness about it.
Because if many people learn this, many people will change the world and it would be better for our future and it would change faster. Because many people are learning and many people are doing.
So this is just a small snippet, but students have been engaging a lot in different social and environmental issues through the year, and we've only finished 4 months of this program. So through the year, we've collected some data through internal assessments on what is it that the students have learned. And some of the things that we identified were, students had an increased knowledge about rights and duties. So when something is violated, so for example, if there are children working in factories, they can tell you exactly what rights are violated based on the Constitution. Another thing that we noticed was students had improved vocabulary. So this picture that you see are some of the words that they learned in class. Not only can they read these words, they can also explain to you what each of these mean. They also had a chance to improve their own analytical abilities because they had to read a lot of complex newspaper articles, videos, and explain issues. So for example, they could read about infrastructure issues in government schools and explain why it affected the learning of students in those schools. And lastly, one of the biggest things that we saw is that change in their beliefs about responsibility and creating impact. Typically, at the beginning of the year when students came in, they saw creating impact as something that is the adult's responsibility. But when they had the chance to learn about activists such as Greta Thunberg, who's only 16, it changed their perspective of who's a change maker and when can you really start making change. So this year the program was really small. We had it only with 40 students in one class in grade 4. Next year we plan to take it up to grades 2, 4, 5 and 7. Similar to what Anuj said, we're going to build this program very organically. Even next year we're going to introduce it in half the divisions because this is a completely new program that we're designing internally for the first time. So we want to make sure that our students have the best experience and our teachers are ready for something like this, because it's very different from our typical Exceed curriculum. Hopefully, if this program is a success next year, in the year after 21-22, we plan to scale it across all grades. So starting from grade 1 to grade 10 in all the schools across our network.